You know, in the movies when, like a lot of times if you watch a movie, it's pretty funny because people will be standing like this close to each other when they're having conversations.
Yep.
No one does that.
In interacting with so many people recently, I've become very aware that I've always thought I had a pretty normal, like, sense of personal space, but you realize, like, where other people's boundaries are when you sort of, like, ease in on them and they ease back right away.
So I'm with Mike Merrill. You are... There's a lot of interesting things about you. You're the most interesting thing is you're publicly traded.
Well, that's probably the second most interesting.
The second? What's the most interesting?
Handsome?
Alright. Yeah, I'm sure.
First most interesting is that I'm publicly
traded. I'm sure there are people out there, a lot of people out there, think you're handsome.
I'm trying to promote the idea of myself as handsome. Now that I've got some competition, Jason's maybe playing me. It's like, you know, who's more handsome?
So explain this. So okay. You're publicly traded. And
yes.
Then Jason Bateman bought the rights to your story or whatever.
So if we back way up, 2008, I launched this project to sell shares of myself so that people that I was doing various projects with, usually like internet web media projects with, we could all kind of collaborate together. And I was like, okay, but if we're all pooling money together, there should be a way for the people that pooled in, you know, put the most money in that pool to have the most say. So let's vote based on how much money you put in. I was like, oh, capitalism has solved this problem, right? Just vote with shares.
Yeah.
As opposed to sort of every one person getting one vote.
Because capitalism solves, like, most problems.
Right. It's actually a much more fair system. If everybody can just vote once, then you're saying that the person that does the least amount of work is the same as the person that does the most amount of work.
Oh,
that's clearly not fair. Like, playground rule style of fair is capitalism, right? Like, 6-year-olds understand capitalism. They understand fairness. So, I took that model and built up this system. And as it sort of evolved, people were more interested in control of my personal life than they were control of these various media programs. So, it became much less about, hey, what new weird projects are you going to do, and more about what my diet was going to be like, how much I should work out, whether I should...
So what's been the most interesting personal change that you've had to put up to this, like?
I think the most interesting one, and the one that sort of ends up telling the rest of this story, was I had come out of a relationship that had lasted 5 years, and then I kind of like took some time off and didn't date anyone for a while, and just trying to figure out like, well, what do I want in a relationship? You know, like, I don't want to fall into something. I don't want to just be like flattered by attention necessary. You know, like, I feel like I'm someone who likes people, and it's easy for me to like a person. So I just wanted to be very careful and intentional that I didn't enter into a relationship where the person I was interested with, we had distant, like very different views of our future, right? Because that was kind of the underpinnings of what happened in my previous relationship. So I said, well, ultimately this should be a shareholder decision, because one of my rules is anything you would normally ask your friends advice for me is a shareholder decision.
So all these people, how many people at this point have shares in you?
I would say it's hard to tell because people are selling shares and buying shares. Some have money in their accounts, some have shares. But at this point, there was probably around 250 shareholders. Not all of whom were always active, right?
Yeah.
Kind of like as any sort of like curve of ownership, there's a few people that own a lot of shares and then a lot of people that own a few shares, kind of thing. So it follows that model pretty closely. So what I did is I started dating, and I would kind of write about these dates, and then I would ask people, kind of like, well, this is how I thought it went. What do you think? Should I keep dating this person? And so I got kind of like an approval rating, kind of like a presidential candidate has, of how each one was going. Eventually, one of the people that I was dating, she bought shares and voted for herself, which I thought was a good sign.
Oh, yeah.
Down.
Wow.
Things progressed. We entered into an exclusive relationship agreement. It was a contract that the shareholders ratified and approved. And yeah, so like right now we're in the midst of our third relationship agreement.
Oh, my.
It's a 2-year agreement. holds their shares. I mean,
look how Jason Bateman, this thing writes itself.
I know, exactly. So that story of the romance project ended up getting a lot of media attention, and then that's where the movie opportunity came in, was the rights to that, to sort of My Life, and that Wired article were sold and would be, you know, developed into a film.
Wow. Do you want to get some coffee? You want to go here, or do you want to go down to water?
Let's go down to water.
Right.
I'm a big Water Avenue fan. Nothing against Coopers, but
it's a nice day.
Being in Portland, is I am a bit of a coffee snob. I feel like I'm a reluctant coffee snob. Like, I don't
really
want to be. I want to just drink coffee. Dude. But because all coffee here is good, now when I have less than that, I'm like, oh, it's not as good.
I like coffee, but I'll tell you, some of the most enjoyable coffee is like that Dunkin' Donuts coffee.
See,
you know? And it's like, I don't know what it is. It's just strange. It's like, I really enjoy good coffee, but I also like really...
Are you from the East Coast or
no?
Okay.
I'm from Oregon.
Okay. I was just like, East Coasters have a weird thing about their Dunkin' Donuts coffee. I didn't know if you were falling into that.
No, but I can understand why.
Okay.
You know what? One thing that they do is they... I think they put their donuts next to the coffee, so it kind of...
Oh, it's like this Pavlovian response. You know, like the dog of the drool. Yes.
Pavlovian
response, where you're like, oh, I get donuts. I get coffee.
I don't know. Well, look at that building. They just chunked out sides of it.
I like that better than the brand new building stuff.
Yeah, I think this area is kind of crazy. You know they're going to put parking meters down here soon?
No, I did not know that. It makes sense. Parking is terrible.
Rights to this story of this, like, person that this guy Mike Merrill, who sells shares of himself and lets people decide on what's going to happen in his life.
Interesting part of that is,
and he's going to play you. In
yes.
This.
Yeah. I think he'll star and direct. So assuming that I'm the star in the story of my own life.
Okay. So if it wasn't Jason Bateman. If it wasn't Jason Bateman, who else would you pick to play you as you?
Dwayne Johnson. I mean, just as sort of a fantasy, you know. And
it would change the movie to be a little bit more of a action movie.
Like kind of a finance revenge flick. We haven't really seen much of that yet. Let's invent a new genre.
I do like that. You know what? My favorite genre is like sci-fi action dramedy, you know?
Oh, like the guy with the crab beard. District 9.
Wow, that wasn't that funny.
Oh, you want the comedy in there. You want the laughs.
Yeah, I like the funny.
Or
the drama funny.
Like Men in Black?
Oh yeah, that's good, but not enough romance in that, you know?
Okay.
I should write movies.
You should write. Oh, that's one of my projects, by the way.
Oh, what?
So I have this project called Story Bank, where I hire people to create works of fiction, but they do it under a work for hire, so that I own all of the intellectual property of the idea that I vaguely assign them.
Uh-huh.
And so mostly it's been these science fiction stories, but I'm working on one that's a movie treatment.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh,
I shouldn't give any spoilers.
So
this kind of combines the business and the occult.
Hey, that's super awesome. Yeah. I love that idea. You should, sign me up, man. You might need to hire an editor after you hire.
You know, that's part of it. Yeah.
Bread and butter. That's cool. I didn't know that.
I like the idea of playing with these kind of larger scale media and corporate structures, but bringing them down and making them kind of smaller and more manageable.
Yeah.
I think for never owned stock before, and they find it, like, very understandable because there's only one market, there's only one stock being traded, right? It's a very simplified version of that.
Yeah. Why are you the only person that sells stock in yourself? Or are you? Are there other people doing this?
Different people have done variations on this idea. Uh-huh. As far as I know, I'm the only one doing it to this level of actually having the market that gives me the fluctuating share price. Like, this morning, somebody cashed out. It's like, I'm done. And so, because he was done, stock price went down because he just wanted to sell his last remaining shares.
Could he just sell them to anyone?
Whatever the lowest
your
price
girlfriend
was that he
or
could
something?
Get. I think it was this guy, one of the other shareholders, whoever had the lowest price.
Oh, wow.
This guy, Mark Eckley, I think. So,
wow.
Yeah, so he got a good deal on a couple shares because this other guy wanted out. My share price is down, right? But it should be, because this guy no longer wants to own shares. His idea of what he's like, I'm done with this project, right?
Yeah, I could understand
why. He might have good reason. Like, but the fact that he's done with it, I didn't like woo him enough and draw him in. He shouldn't. My share price is down.
You think selling the movie rights would be
that's still like probably a year out though. Maybe he's got, you know, something important he has to buy.
Jeez, how long does it take to make a movie? Right?
Yeah, honestly.
Huh. All right.
All right, coffee?
All right.
Yeah.
All right.